You might have heard the terms line level, mic level, and instrument level when talking about the inputs and outputs of various audio gear. But there are also some other important signal levels that you may not have come across. So let's explain what all of these are and how they relate to each other so that you can better understand how to interconnect your audio gear. Line level is the standard signal level used in audio systems. It is the voltage level that audio signals are typically transmitted at between audio devices in the studio. The outputs of an audio interface, for example, are line level. Mixing consoles, compressors, and effects units in general, modern synthesizers, DJ mixers, hi-fis, and consumer electronics such as TVs and MP3 players are all devices that operate at line level. So having established that, let's see what other audio levels are present in a studio and what we can do to convert them to line level so that they can interface with the rest of our audio gear. Microphones typically produce a weaker signal. The level of that signal is known as mic level, and in order to be able to use microphones with other gear in the studio, we need to amplify that signal to line level. This is why we need a mic preamp, which takes the mic signal and raises it to line level. In between mic and line level is instrument level. This is the signal level produced by electric guitars and basses, and by a lot of vintage keyboards and synths. Instrument level is typically weaker than line level, although some instruments are capable of producing strong enough signals that don't need amplification to reach line level. Still, they shouldn't be connected directly to line level equipment due to them having a high impedance. If you want to know more about impedance and how to plug in your instruments correctly, go watch our Hi-Z video. So, if we want to connect an instrument level signal to a line level input, we have three choices. One is to use a dedicated instrument preamp, such as the many analog and digital guitar and bass preamps in rack and pedal format. Another is to connect it to a Hi-Z input on a mic preamp, found in most audio interfaces and professional mic preamps. The third way is to connect it to a DI box, which will transform the signal to a low impedance microphone level signal, which we can connect directly to a mic preamp as if it were a microphone. So as I said, you may have heard of these three before, but there are three other signal levels that are extremely useful to know so that you know how to connect your gear without blowing it up. This is the weakest signal level of all, and it's produced by turntables used to play vinyl records. Phono signals need to be connected to special phono preamps that amplify that tiny signal to line level and equalize it, in order to compensate for the physical limitations of the medium, basically boosting the bass and attenuating the high frequencies. On the other end of the scale, speaker level is the strongest audio signal level. It's produced by power amplifiers driving passive speakers, such as in guitar and bass amps, passive studio monitors, and consumer hi-fi systems. Speaker level outputs can produce signals with very high voltages, which could potentially destroy your gear if you plugged it into a line level, or even worse, a mic or instrument level input. Also, a lot of speaker level connections, especially in guitar and bass amps, are made using TS connectors, which are identical to the ones used on instrument cables. Always double check that you're using a speaker TS cable and not an instrument one. Using an instrument cable on a speaker connection, especially on a high wattage amp, is more than likely going to melt the cable and also damage the amp in the process. Now, a more niche audio signal level is the one produced by modular synthesizers. Modular synth signals can be used both as audio signals and as control voltages, and there are many different standards depending on the manufacturer, the most popular one being Eurorack. Modular level signals are typically higher than line level, so they must be attenuated before connecting to a line level input on a mixer, interface, or effects unit. You could use a simple VCA module for that, or a more dedicated output module that can also feature balanced outputs, headphone outputs, and so on. Now, if you have more questions about specific setups, leave us a comment down below and we'll try to help out. But also check out our other videos over here that can help you understand how to connect your audio gear in the right way. Thanks for watching and see you next time on Mix Signals. Bye-bye.